Every human is different from the rest due to the variances of genes and behavior. In day to day, we can see many people with different physical well-being, such as heights, weights, and skin colors. But the main point which we must remember is that we all have the same red blood running inside our body. All the humans are beautiful from outside, but one's inner beauty is the most precious thing when compared with handsomeness and prettiness. People should have bright hearts and beautiful minds rather than having an attractive face, which hides an unpleasant heart with cruelty. Unfortunately, there are many beautiful souls who are born with rare disorders, which make their appearance a little bit different than normal people's. They try so hard to not make a gap between them and other people, but the sharp mouths of such terrible people will ruin all of their hard effort. So, today we found a story about a brave girl who had a severe disorder and was bullied by many people, including both children and adults in her childhood, but gained confidence from those opinions to stand up on her own and build up bright and a promising future for herself. Before going on, make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to be notified with our latest updates. Elizabeth Ann Velasquez, also known as Lizzie, was born in the year 1989 in Texas, United States. She was the first child of the Velasquez couple, who was looking forward to have children. Even though they were happy to have Lizzie, they were also a little bit worried about her condition. It was because little Lizzie was born with a rare genetic disease called Marfanoid Progeroid Lipodystrophy Neotonal Syndrome, which affects the heart, eyes, and bones, and also the growth of the body, including gaining weight. Her everything was pretty fine, other than her fragile body and face. She was completely rich in mental health and responded to her environment from the beginning itself. She had never thought she was a little bit different from the other kids of her age until she started attending preschool. Her parents treated her well and never let her know that she was different. But after attending the preschool, she saw that the other kids' appearance is different from hers, and they did not want to be friends with her. They looked at her with scary looks and never came near her. She could not think why this was happening to her. Why are the kids pointing at her? Why were they not talking with her, but about her? She was really sad, as we can say that it was a tough situation for a little girl of 5 years old to face. Even though she was a little girl, she thought of not telling her parents the weird situation at school, but things become more and more complicated little by little, and she had nothing to do except telling her parents. Hearing their daughter's situation, the parents felt so sad, but they comforted their daughter by telling it was not a thing to cry over, as there is nothing wrong with her, and she was only a little bit smaller than the other kids in the kindergarten. They also said that she is a beautiful girl with a smart brain and can accomplish anything she needed. These words made her believe in herself, and she was strongly motivated to do her work at school with a clear mind. She once told the media that the strong foundation laid by her parents built faith in herself, and the love and care given was incredible, as she was so happy to be around all of her family members. They never teased or bullied her. Instead, they taught her how to be happy in any situation. Growing up, she got to know that she was completely different from the other kids around her. She also got to know that it was because of a syndrome which will never be cured. She felt so sad after knowing about her situation, but she did not blame her parents or her doctors. She only blamed herself for being born. When she started her teenage years, she tried to blend herself in with the other girls of her own age, but they were not looking forward to be friends with her. With all those negativity, she did not downcast herself. Instead, she uplifted herself and managed her school life. While in school, she started to believe that no matter what or how others treated her, she will do her best and spend her high school life effectively. She decided that she should bravely join in extra activities which the school had provided them with. She started off by setting herself as the staff writer for the school newspaper and was also in charge for the photography of the school's yearbook. She did not only participate in the literary work, but also joined the cheer group at the school. She was fascinated with the uniform of the cheer group so much that she felt like a superhero whenever she wore that dress. She felt the same vibe as if her family members were around when she wore that dress. Everything was going well until one day, something made her devastated. It all happened when she was 17 years old. She was doing her homework in her room and then searched for some music when she saw a familiar thumbnail and clicked on it, and saw the title as The World's Ugliest Woman. The video was still loading, and Lizzie never thought that the video would break her heart into pieces. It was a soundless video of Lizzie, taken when she was 16 years old. Her heart stopped when she saw this footage. She stopped watching and started reading comments, thinking the people who watched it might have been criticizing the person who uploaded it. But the dark truth was that other people have commented so badly that Lizzie felt horrible. Some said the world would be a better place if she was not in it, and tips on how to get out of this world. The fragile self-confidence she grew up all these years ripped apart in a few seconds. She knew no matter how hard she tried to forget, this would not easily fade away. So she tried to build up herself upon this video itself. Lizzie's father was the one who persuaded her not to feel ashamed or down on herself. Although his words were blunt at that time for Lizzie, she now thinks that those words were the best she did hear at that time. She made a target that someday in the future she will tell her story to all the people around the world as a help to the people who are suffering their lives due to the problems like hers. To achieve her goal, she studied hard at college and graduated. She earned a bachelor's degree in communication at the Texas State University. Lizzie did not take any opinions of other people with bad mouths. She did just well and made her first steps in achieving her goal. She started her own online platform where she helped people like her and also motivated other people on different aspects. In the year 2013, she made a motivational speech at TEDx, which went viral and was viewed more than 9 million times. A few days later, Sarah Hirsch-Bordo, the producer of the popular program TED Woman, invited Lizzie for a dinner and talked about her life. She was not here only to talk about programs, she was here to make friends with her. Lizzie gladly told her a story where the producer asked Lizzie if she would like to help shine a light on one of her stories. She gladly accepted the invitation and went for the shoots with a bright smile. The name of the production was called A Brave Heart, a Lizzie Velasquez story. This film later won 9 acclaims at Film Awards. The producer, Bordo, said, "Lizzie's story is one that is so unique, but the feeling of being bullied, the feeling of being a victim of someone's meanness, is something that everyone feels." Later on, Lizzie also got invited to work in a film with Tina Meyer, the mother of Megan Meyer, who hanged herself in 2006 due to the negative impact of being bullied on MySpace. While filming, she always thought that she carried the memories of Megan with her. She believed that the innocent people who were being bullied must be given care and protection by their family members and other trusted and loved ones because they should know that they are not alone or else there is always a light at the end of the tunnel. Lizzie and Bordo both have started an anti-bullying campaign, which became a huge success, and now are looking forward for a federal anti-bullying bill, which is now pending in Congress. In early days, bullying was face-to-face and ended in a short period of time. But today, it has no end because technological devices have let us be connected 24 hours and 7 days continuously. The anti-bullying bill, which started 8 years ago, is still on process, as it requires schools to create policies aiming anti-public bullying. Lizzie also suggested that schools should have a more updated open communication system in order to stop bullying and for kids to easily speak up if they have any problem. With all these work going on, Lizzie also has to spend time on her own health matters. She has a weak immune system, and for her to survive as a whole, she should at least rest for a whole day. The doctors have always said that she should protect herself before helping others. Lizzie now has more than 500,000 followers who compliment Lizzie's hard work and meaningful speeches. Many young girls and boys all around the world send her messages and emails. They tell her how helpful her speeches were for them, that they could overcome many of their problems. Lizzie said, "I can feel their smile through their words. To be able to look at those comments and then just get encouragement from them and know that I'm living the life that I'm supposed to is what keeps me going on every day." We can see people like Lizzie from all around the world, but most of them are not as brave as Lizzie. We should try to help them gain confidence in themselves and to retain themselves as they really are. From school itself, children must be taught how to treat each other and they should be acknowledged about how to act when being bullied. So that's the end of today's video, and we hope you enjoyed this mesmerizing story about Lizzie, the brave heart girl. Make sure you have subscribed to our channel and hit the bell to be notified with our latest updates. See you in our next video.